What's up guys, here's Twitty, hope you're doing well. In today's video we're gonna mess with some Boxer 6 engines. So I built a Boxer 6 engine, or a Boxer 6 cylinder, whichever way you'd like to say it, a while ago, and that thing was a nasty machine. Like, it made way too much power for what I need. So this engine is gonna be used in tomorrow's video, or in this case tomorrow's live stream rather. I might do a video actually, when I come to think of it. Anyway. So we're going to make this thing just over 3 liters in displacement, and we're going to run 5 valves per cylinder, aluminum heads, all the nice deals, right? We'll also use quality sliders that are on plus 15. I'm going to go with a heavy forged rotating assembly just so that I can have something that can support power and big power at it. Because yes, this thing is going to be ran on nitro meth. I know I run a lot of engines on nitro meth, but there's very good reason for it. I like to make a whole load of power, and that engine can facilitate all that power. Now, here's where the tricky part comes in. I don't think it's going to give me too many headaches, to be honest. I'm shooting for around 2,500 to 3,000 horsepower, if that's possible. And we're already at 1,400 horsepower, which is mad. So I know that the exhaust size is going to give me a headache or two. So I'm going to increase that up to where it is currently, and then we're going to go and mess with some, well, in this case RPM. So we can rev this thing all the way out to an astounding 9,900 RPM. Ooh, nearly said horsepower. This is not a 6-cylinder. So we can, I'm actually going to leave it at 10,000 RPM, I think that's a good place to leave. So this engine looks quite massive, and I think this thing is going to go into a smaller race car type chassis. Almost 2,000 horsepower just sitting there all pretty. Mad. Anyway. So we're going to go and increase the intercooler size a little bit. And also I see our headers are starting to give us some headaches. So we're going to leave this at 3.4. Go back down here and just increase the header size. We'll just fix that whole power type of boost. So I'm not looking to go too crazy, but a little crazy, it's good. We are of course running VGTs, or variable geometry turbochargers, and that's where our power comes in. So that's nice and linear, and it runs up quite good. It's not too linear, but it's decent enough to where I can play with it, so to speak. Add some of this to it again. 2,600 horsepower, awesome. Gonna play a little with the ignition timing, or rather in this case with the cam profile. This thing used to be ignition timing, so that's why I refer to it as ignition timing. So that's really on me, but anyway, nearly 3,000 horsepower, and we're almost to the number I actually want to be at. So I'm pretty darn happy with that. If our turbo doesn't explode. As I see the headers up here, problem again. it'll be fine, don't worry about it. 3000, let's shoot for 3100. I think that's a good number to leave this engine at. So there we go, 3100. And can we lower the compression a bit? Does not help. Raise the compression a bit. Let's shoot for 3.2, because 3 liter engine, 3200 horsepower, that's a good ring. And we're also extremely reliable, quite frankly, for this engine type, so that's pretty darn good. We're gonna leave that there at 11.1, and we're gonna go back here and play with them with some more stuff, so make them a little more powers. Okay, so that's fully advanced, perfect. Let's increase this a little bit, do that a little more. That does not help. Why does not that help? Oh yeah, I forgot nitro meth. My bad. So 3000 C, okay, yeah, that's good. So that does not make power. Does this make power now? Yes, it does. Beautiful. Leave that there. So that's close as could be. This is gonna mess with some stuff. I know that. Yeah, like I said, it's gonna mess with some stuff. Hey, 3,200 horsepower. Yes. Beautiful. So that's where I'm going to leave it. That's really awesome. You hit our power goal. gonna throw a quick paint scheme on it, something that will make it pop really good. I'm gonna go with a carbon fiber. Let's go with the yellow. Probably, have I done yellow engines? I don't know. If you like the sound of this engine being put in a chassis, do consider to like, comment, share, and subscribe, because really that does help me out. Now that I've done all my YouTubery bits, let's continue with the video. Let's go here, let's do that. Yes, there we go. That's a beautiful bright yellow. Now I'm just gonna add a accent color like that. Beautiful. So now we're gonna make two dyno pools. Of course, one looking at the engine, one looking at the graph. Don't know why I flipped the graph up when I was looking at the engine, but anyway, let's go. Yeah, I still can't get over the way this flat 6 engine sounds. That this sounds absolutely to the next level. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.